Hello dear patients, today we are going to review the topic of bump in the mouth after cunnilingus. A man came to us, he had unprotected orogenital contact, that is cunnilingus with an unknown woman. After that he carefully examined his mouth and he found a bump there in the area of cheek on the left along the line of teeth occlusion. You can see it on the picture. This bump is a red pink node. During palpation it is quite dense and it slightly scared the patient. Its size was relatively small, about 1 cm in diameter. What can we think about during observation? First of all, during such contacts, it's necessary to take analysis from mouth cavity for sexually transmitted infections. You can watch several separate videos about it on our channel. However, in theory, this bump can be related to tertiary syphilis, but for its development quite a lot of time is needed. So this bump is not related to cunnilingus that happened several days ago. What it is? This is a fibrous growth. You can watch a theoretical video about what fibrous growth is on our channel. Indeed, it is unlikely to have been developed after cunnilingus, and after careful examination of mouth cavity after sexual contact, a lot of patients note the things that were there for quite a long time, in particular this fibrous growth. Usually these growths are either a node on a broad base, as in our case, or on a peduncle. Usually it's less than 2 cm in diameter. The consistency of node, as in our case, is quite dense, and sometimes it's bilateral, and this is the most common benign tumor of oral cavity. One of the most characteristic places of this tumor localization is mucous membrane of cheeks along the line of occlusion, and it can also be located on tongue, on gums, as well as on lips. Basically, this is a scary growth of so-called connective tissue. Gradually, with time and age, the tumor gradually increases in size. Usually, it's not dangerous from the viewpoint of malignant oncology. As for the treatment, there is only one method – its removal. The removal can be done using more superficial methods, for example, using liquid nitrogen, as it fits quite well for removal of scars. You can watch a separate video about it on our channel, and it fits quite well for removal of such fibrous growths. Also, a radial wave method with local anesthesia can be used as well. Such tumor does not resolve on its own, and it gradually increases. That's why, if it obstructs the patient, then this tumor can be removed by these two widely used methods. Therefore, if any complaints on oral cavity appear after cunnilingus, it's necessary to do smear tests for sexually transmitted infections, as well as to do blood tests. However, this cannot always be the cause. The causes may be different. They may be the ones you didn't notice before as symptoms. They can manifest secondary to an increased awareness of your oral cavity, sexual organs, and after some relatively recent sexual contacts. However, for checkup for sexually transmitted infections, for diagnostics of such rashes in oral cavity and in the area of sexual organs, you can consult dermatoneurologists and urologists of our paid medical center of Dermatovenerologic Dispensary in Moscow. We have experienced specialists who do diagnostics, treatment and removal of such neoplasms. We are waiting for you in our clinic. Please subscribe to our channels on YouTube and Instagram. Thank you for your attention.